In this short presentation, we will explore the features and benefits of Radio Access Control, or RAC, which provides powerful new security capabilities for the Trio Q data radio. Cybercrime is a growing threat to all connected infrastructure. Hackers are becoming more sophisticated. They may be individuals, small groups, or even foreign governments. Agencies such as the ITU, ISO, IEEE, and others are developing new standards for security tools and network services, which are in demand by security professionals and end users. Governments are developing new regulations which wireless vendors must meet. State-of-the-art regulatory compliance is a must on many projects. As a result, end users, whether private companies, government agencies, or military, are increasingly demanding that vendors provide a high level of security in products and solutions. For a fully secure system, the use of AES-GCM encryption, along with RAC, is highly recommended. AES-GCM is available as of Trio Q firmware version 2.4. Systems with AES encryption or no encryption can be migrated to AES-GCM. AES-GCM is an advanced encryption system using 64-bit authentication tags. Encryption keys are automatically rotated on a regular basis with key management based upon radio access control. Also, the use of AES-GCM provides protection against replay attacks. In a system operating with radio access control, one radio is configured as the authenticator, typically the system's entry point radio. All other radios are configured as supplicants and must authenticate before they can send or receive data over the radio network. Additional radios are onboarded or invited to the network in a simple and secure manner. The authenticator and supplicants mutually authenticate each other using the DTLS protocol by sharing their X.509 certificates. Once authorized, certificates are valid indefinitely until revoked by the administrator. Several onboarding methods exist, and we will review each of them. One-time passwords, or OTP, are used to securely onboard supplicants with the authenticator using a special file called an invitation. Zero-touch onboarding creates an invitation that combines an OTP and a radio configuration. It is intended to be applied to radios in a factory default state, such as during installation of a new remote radio. Invitations are created on the authenticator radio. A template configuration is first created and then chosen for use in the zero-touch invitation. The user can change the template's IP address, which may be the only unique aspect of the configuration. Typically, the zero-touch invitation is automatically applied to a radio in the factory default state via an inserted USB memory or thumb drive. Alternately, the zero-touch invitation may be uploaded through a web or text user interface. OTP invitations are primarily used to migrate remote radios in an existing wireless system using either AES or no encryption to an RAC-based system using AES-GCM. This process creates an invitation that only includes a one-time password. The invitation is typically transferred over the air, but can be uploaded from a locally connected PC. Supplicants are migrated using a process that results in minimal downtime. First, all supplicants are configured to use RAC and AES-GCM, and then the authenticator is reconfigured. After the authenticator reboots, it begins the onboarding process with all supplicants. Manual certificate exchange allows the administrator to onboard a radio by copying certificates between the authenticator and the supplicants. This option may be chosen when over-the-air onboarding is not feasible or desirable, for example, when preparing a spare radio which will not be placed into operation immediately. If using manual certificate exchange, it is typically presumed that each radio has been pre-configured as part of an operational system. Optionally, an entire system could be configured manually. Each radio would be reconfigured for RAC mode as either authenticator or supplicant. Then the certificate of the authenticator would be uploaded into supplicants, and the supplicant certificates would be uploaded into the authenticator. The most likely use, however, will be when replacing an authenticator. The new authenticator must be loaded with the original authenticator's configuration file, its recovery password, and the archived radio access control list, which includes supplicant certificates. Supplicants will then authenticate with the new authenticator after challenging it with the recovery password. At the bottom of the RAC page is the Radio Access Control List, or RACL. The system administrator manages the RACL within the authenticator, specifying which radios are allowed access to the network. Supplicants have an RACL also, but it's likely that the only radio listed will be the authenticator. The serial number of each radio is listed, along with its authorization level and current state. The list will specify that a radio is authorized and synced if it is ready to communicate. The state may be pending if the radio has been invited but has not begun the onboarding process, or syncing if it is in the process of onboarding. Existing radios may be suspended temporarily if not currently required, for example, a spare radio. The radio may be authorized again. A radio may be disabled if it has been lost or stolen. This forces the radio to return to factory default condition upon its next authentication attempt, or a radio may be deleted if it's no longer required. Note also that the view may be updated either once by pressing the refresh button, or repeatedly by selecting a refresh rate. The network list is found in the radio's monitoring menu. It provides a quick look at the status of communication with other radios and includes the IP address and serial number of each radio, along with when it was last heard and the authorization state. Numerous diagnostic parameters are also provided for maintenance purposes. For example, RSSI, as heard by the remote radio. This is a very helpful tool for verifying which radios are connected and how well the links are operating. The event log, also located in the monitoring menu, provides a time-stamped list of significant events which have occurred to the radio. This can include items such as authentication of supplicants, changes in the RACL, and when encryption key rotations have occurred. In summary, with the release of Radio Access Control and AES GCM encryption, the Trio Q Data Radio now includes the ability to manage remote radio access to a highly secure wireless network. Thank you for your interest in the advanced Trio Q Data Radio.